गुड इवनिंग लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, बॉयज एंड गर्ल्स, वेलकम टू जहाने मन। एज वी ऑल नो दैट नाउअडेज वी आर इंटरव्यूइंग द पीपल ट्राइंग टू नो देयर एस्पिरेशंस फॉर 2021, एंड टुडे वी हैव अ स्पेशल गेस्ट विद अस, शबीना शेख, सीओओ ऑफ लेड बाय फाउंडेशन। लेट्स वेलकम शबीना शेख। हेलो शबीना।
Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity, Halima.
How are you?
I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm good. It's nice to see you here in Jahane Man.
Same. Pleasure is all mine.
So, Shabina, first let us know what is Led By, because this name is very new for us.
So, Led By Foundation is a Harvard-incubated social startup which is trying to increase the representation of Indian Muslim women in corporate and professional spaces. So if we look at the current statistics, the percentage of Muslim women going to undergraduate and postgraduate itself is lower than it should have been, and that being translated into employment is much lower. At Led By, we did a study wherein we tried to see how many women from the Muslim community are on the boards of the top 500 corporates. And we found out that it has been underrepresented by a hundredth of what it should have been. So we are trying to bridge that gap.
Good, great.
And we are doing that by providing a 3-month intensive summer fellowship program to college going girls who are either in the final year or the pre-final year of their either undergrad or postgrad. And we are equipping them with 3 kinds of skills. So they will go through a series of workshops which will have professional skills and the personal skills as a bundle. So for the professional skills, we have institutes like Harvard, MIT, and Columbia who are coming to us with a curriculum which is contextualized to these girls, Indian Muslim girls. And for the personal development skills, we have sessions like storytelling, personal narrative, creating an empowering story of these girls where they just don't rewrite their own story, but also write it in a very empowering manner. So this helps actually when they are writing SOPs for institutes or when they are giving job interviews after their college. So this is the workshops part of it. Then we have a 360 degree mentoring model where we have all of these amazing advisors with more than 10 years of experience. These girls have a direct access to those mentors. So what we, the lacuna in the community right now is that we do not have enough role models. I think Dr. Halima ma'am is also trying to bridge that exact gap where you're trying to bring in role models and showcasing them to the society and the community, right? So we are trying to do something similar. We are bringing in a platform and connecting all these women and giving these 24 girls who get selected access to them. And then these again, so that's the down mentoring that happens. These girls again go through a peer mentoring with the rest of the 23 girls who are from diverse backgrounds. So in the 2020 cohort, we had a 50-50 breakup of STEM, non-STEM, and from representation from about 19 states. So it's a very diverse place and they get learn a lot from peers. And one final deliverable is that these girls have to go back to their high school, select a school-going girl and mentor her throughout the process. So which is why we call it a 360 degree mentoring model. The final module is wherein we are providing them with an executive coaching session where these girls have access to international executive coaches who sit with them, help them understand their strengths, interests, and set their goals, and also map their next 5-year career steps. So this is the foundation's fellowship program.
It's really great, like great effort. And how come Shabina Sheikh is in this organization?
So it's been a roller coaster journey for me. And so if you see my background, it's been very different from, I was not initially part of the social development side. So I started off as I am an electronics engineer, and then I worked with a corporate for 2 years as a developer, and then I moved on and did my MBA from IIM Ahmedabad. again moved to corporate space where I worked in corporate strategy, IT development, data analytics. But throughout the process, from the very beginning, there are some moments in my life that have really influenced me, which I talk about in a lot of other sessions as well, is this one story that happened with me when I was a kid. So when I was 4 years old, my parents, I come from a rural area in Andhra Pradesh. So my parents were then deciding whether or not to join me in school, and if they did, where to join me. So that was a decision that they had to make when they were not financially really stable. And also it's a conservative setup where girl children are not really encouraged to go for education, and it was considered to be an additional burden on the family. Now my parents, to my advantage and my privilege, and I'm really thankful to them for that, decided that I should get the best possible education no matter what. And my father then went to this best school in my locality, whatever it was, and asked for an admission for me. Surprisingly, the school admission, the admission committee declined an admission, saying that, so your community, we have tried to bring in a lot of girls, but what happens is after a point, you lose interest, either because education is not important to you, and then you drop out. So that creates a problem for our numbers. So which is why we are not taking in any girl students from, we are not interested in taking a girl student. So what my father did then was the biggest privilege of my life, is that he went and requested the school principal and the admission office every single day until they gave me an admission finally.
Oh, great.
I did my entire schooling from there. I ended up being a district topper and one of the state toppers, but that wouldn't have been possible without that one incident. And a lot of high potential girls, a lot of the girls with like very super achieving mindset do not have that kind of support. So that is something I realized. And then moving forward, when I was doing my engineering and even working, I realized I was most often the only Muslim girl in the class. In my engineering, I was the only Muslim girl. Surprisingly, in IIM Ahmedabad, when I was doing my master's, again, the representation was very skewed. We were about 2 girls out of a 500 batch.
So you had the Muslim girls there in IIM?
Yeah.
Oh, that's really a privilege, because this is also my experience, because wherever I go for any training or any sort of workshops, I usually I found myself that I am the only one. Even in Ahmedabad also, when I was there, among 29 people, I found myself that I was the only one. But salute to your father, because you know he is the main, I think, source, and because of him only you are a great achiever now.
Yeah, my parents have been my backbone throughout, and I also understand that a lot of children do not have that kind of privilege, not because the parents are not encouraging, because of a lot of other aspects to it. Even in spite of having all of that, I had very few role models in my life who I can look up to in from the community. So these are the things that kept boggling me as I moved forward. And so I always wanted to do something about it. And when I knew about Ruha, the founder of Led by Foundation, by the way, she's a master's candidate from Harvard University. Before that, she's a doctor. She has worked extensively on public health. And she is exceptional, highly motivated, and very vision-driven. So she had started the foundation, and I had a chance to talk to her. And it just fit in that what was in mind was something she was doing. And then we started working on this. We completed the first fellowship program. We could bring in Shibana Azmi, and the first woman ever in the world, first Muslim woman ever in the world to have received a Nobel Prize. Dr. Shirin Ibadi as a chief guest for our first graduation ceremony. So that has been a success. And so what we faced in our lives are the gaps that we are trying to bridge through the foundation. We are trying to give the girls a role model. We are trying to give them direction. We are trying to give them the skills that are necessary for them to bridge all these gaps that they have.
Wow, that's really very nice to know your story. It's very inspiring and motivating. And I'm very happy that you are here today so that I can present you to my viewers, and they all will be very happy and motivated with this. So Shabina ma'am, you know that this year 2020 was a great challenging year for everyone. And people, they don't have much good to speak about this. I want to know from you that how was the year for you, and whether what type of challenges you faced at professional level or personal level, and what is your overall opinion about this year?
2020 has been indeed very challenging in a lot of ways, especially when it comes to personal relationships. A lot of people have lost a lot of dear ones. I have lost my relatives and many close friends for COVID. It's really sad in that aspect, and a lot of mental health issues have been cropping up. People have been really stressed. This is indeed a very stressful year, because I haven't ever in my life seen such a big lockdown and so much change from 2019 to 2020. But having said that, this year especially has been a year full of opportunities for me and for the foundation, because we tried and we were successful in finding alternatives to whatever was done regularly, and it really worked out. So humans are really great in innovation. Humans are really great in adapting to change, and I think that's what we did. Instead of focusing on what's going bad, we always try to look at what we can do differently or what can help us out in moving out of the situation and making things better. So the entire fellowship program we did virtually. So one surprising fact is that I've been working with the foundation for over 7-8 months now. I haven't met a team member in person. So Ruha was working for out of the US for a while, and one of our social media associates was based out of Dubai. I am based out of India, Vijayawada, and there's another associate in Delhi. So we have been working virtually, and we could connect and we could pull it off, thankfully. Work-wise, it is a very fruitful year for us. And we have been able to reach more than 1,200 students. So we got 1,200 applications for the 2021 fellowship program, which also makes it clear that people are, in spite of colleges being closed, educational institutes being closed, students are still looking for opportunities, and they're finding them through virtual platforms online. So that way, professionally, it has been a very fruitful year for me. Personally, there are some challenges. But a balance, like we always do have challenges, but losing people was the hardest part of it. But again, so when you have a lot of challenges, there's also a lot of learning. So I think personally became more aware of the people who are around me, and stopped taking people for granted that they will be always with me, and started giving people the importance that they deserve.
That's really so touching. Yes, it's really very touching that we normally take the people for granted, especially our close relatives and close friends. We think that they are going to be with us, and we never realize this, that all of a sudden, even the young people whom we have never expected that they are going to expire, they expired during this pandemic. Yeah. So anyways, whatever had happened, because today is the last day and we have to say goodbye to this day. Now, 2021 is approaching. And we have to welcome 2021 with positive vibes and with lots of expectations and hopes. So what is your aspirations for 2021, and are we prepared for those aspirations?
So for me, there are two only. I'm very bad at keeping up New Year resolutions. So I kept my New Year resolutions to a minimum this year. So the first and the most important resolution for me is to get more fit, be healthier, improve. So not to, so 2020 also has taught us the importance of having a healthy lifestyle. So that's what I'm focusing on for 2021. The second part is to continue whatever I'm doing, but with a greater momentum. And 2020 has given me that motivation. I feel 2021 is going to be much better and full of opportunities. So I'm really looking forward to 2021. I'm also looking at learning new skills because I have been recently moving from the corporate IT space to the development sector. So a lot of public skills, personal skills are to be developed. So that's on my agenda. But if I have to put it to two main things, one is physical fitness. Second would be my mental health and being very mindful. These are the two targets I have for 2021.
Okay, thank you very much. And you have in these two targets, you have some of everything, because physical and mental health, that's what we are. Yeah, we combination of these two. I wish you all the best. Now, before we wind up and we leave, I just request you to give some golden suggestions or the advices to our viewers, please.
I have thought about this question. I'm not sure if I'm there yet to give a suggestion to people, but I'll let everybody know a quote of Michelle Obama that I really like. So in simple words, she says, "You may not always have a comfortable life and you will not always be able to solve all of the world's problems at once, but don't ever underestimate the importance you can have, because history has shown us that courage can be contagious and hope can take on a life on its own." The point being that let's be hopeful. Let's look forward to 2021 and it's going to be wonderful. So hope is the basic ingredient for every success. So
yes.
I suggest everybody to be optimistic and hopeful.
Thank you very much. It is really lovely message to all the viewers. And my dear viewers, thank you very much for watching us. I hope this conversation is useful for you. And I wish you all the best and stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Halima ma'am.